try this again. What do I say about all this? We've got an epidemic in this country, and it's with adults messing with young children in a sexual manner. I mean, we like to sit in our little bubbles of our parts of the world and go, well, you know, this Epstein thing, you know, that's out there, that's billionaires, that's, you know, some very sick, very wealthy people doing disgusting things, and but that's in another part of the world, and I'm not personally affected. But here lately, in this part of the country, in the United States, we've had quite the epidemic. Let's see, we had a scout leader. I think that was national news. He was arrested. We have a longtime person in the sheriff's department and his wife involved, been arrested. He's been arrested on 60 counts. I don't know how many for her. This is a married couple. This is a sheriff's officer and a teacher. I was a teacher. Makes me sick. Absolutely sick. We send our children off to these organizations like the Scouts, or, you know, we think that we're doing the good parenting thing and getting them involved and socialized and doing fun activities, and the adults in charge are hurting the children. We send them off to school to get an education, and turns out the teacher is hurting the children. We have a sheriff's officer who's in charge of our safety, and turns out he is anything but safe around our children. There's another one being investigated by this, who's a state police officer. Again, our children are in danger. I thought I was an anomaly back years ago when I got information that a teacher who was a beloved coach was possibly harming children. I told the administration because it is my job to do so. Did they do anything? They did nothing. Thank God, secretly, I took it upon myself to go to the attorney, district attorney, the assistant district attorney at the time, and told him my concerns. Let's see. 4 months later, calls me into the office, and he arrested him on 3 counts. Three children. This man got 2 years for what he did to these 3 boys because they did not testify, because their parents did not want them to go through that, any sort of public scrutiny. And here we are, you know. I went through absolute, you know, almost near, you know, my employment suicide doing that, even though by law it's what I should do, morally it's what I should do. I caught all kind of hell for that one. I was not the favorite employee until he, you know, got arrested, and they kind of looked at me sideways after that. But these are adults. These are adults. And these are our children. I can't even pretend. You know, one of my greatest things in the world is to try and understand why people believe what they believe. Their belief systems. But this is a sickness. I can't wrap my mind around this thought process. How it is they're so depraved that they get some sort of pleasure out of hurting children. It just floors me. Oh, then yesterday, another one at the high school. A high school, not ours, but a high school, not far, arrested. for something with children, a coach. Again, it's everywhere. It's right here where I am. It's in the state I'm in. And people say, well, this has probably been going on forever. We just didn't know about it. Oh, I'm sure there are people doing things in the past that we did not know about. That was very well hidden. But I'm sorry. I think it's escalating. And the reason I think it's escalating is because our morals and values have been flushed down the toilet. Any sort of morality that would keep people in check decades ago, I might go to hell, or this might happen, or that might happen, or people might, it's out the window. What is it, narcissism? The fact that you think that you're always right and that your perspective is the right perspective and what anybody else thinks doesn't matter? I mean, what makes these people tick to think that they can do the things that they do and look in the mirror at themselves every day and think that they're okay somehow? The amount of damage it does to people who have worked with these people for years. No idea. No idea that they were doing what they were doing. The self-doubt it puts into you as a good individual that, oh, well, how did I not see that? Can you imagine being a detective on the police force and you work up along somebody for years and you find out that they do these things to children? I mean, you think, what kind of detective am I that I didn't catch any of this? I didn't know any of this. Well, a lot of the times evil's pretty smart. It's pretty clever. It takes your good heart and your faith in people and it uses it to their advantage. Because, they know that you never think bad of them. I even had somebody yesterday say, I mean, is it going to get to the point where we have to homeschool our children? I mean, this is, yeah. And let me tell you something, as a teacher and the way the system's going in this country, I'm one of them. You're going to lose the good teachers because of what the curriculum and the way things are set up and the micromanaging and the lack of decent behavior amongst a lot of the students that you're teaching, not all of them. Who wants to be in that profession? Who wants to be in a profession where you go to school for all those years, you make as little money as we do, and we're supposed to affect the future of the country? And the amount of disrespect, the lack of considering our safety and mental well-being, the lack of considering the regular students' safety and mental well-being. We've got to make all these modifications for everybody else. What about the regular kids? What about the teachers? What about them? I had a teacher tell me the other day. I don't know how it was mentioned. She said that she had a student. She was out for a few days because she had meetings outside of school, mandatory meetings that you have to go do. And they caught a kid bringing a knife to school because he was going to shank her. Do you know what they did for her and her mental well-being and for that kid? They just moved into a different classroom. 2 days suspension for a knife, threatening a teacher. Moving to a different classroom. She still sees him every day. He's just not in her class. And that's a healthy environment for all the students around this child and her and the other teacher. What's the other teacher going to do? Walk on eggshells because this child might want to shank that teacher? Well, we're not talking about,
inner city, big city, problems. This is a fairly rural area. I mean, what is this? And that's the way they handle it. That's the way they handle it. Well, go to work, teach the children, They don't go through the motions, nothing's actually solved, just move on.